You're welcome to today's seminar. It's good to have you. How's your big week been? All right?
Stressful.
Stressful, is it? Okay. Our seminar this week is focused on the assignment we have, on the deadline for the assignment. It's Monday, the 26th of November. Okay. Now, let's look at the coursework briefing again. We've done this before, but we're revisiting it again. First, our focus is clear. We're looking at energy and sport drink consumption in the UK. So if you get data from the UK, your focus is on the UK, but that doesn't stop you from comparing what's happening in other countries. For instance, things that are happening around Europe in terms of sugar tax, other parts of the world, in South Africa, or perhaps in the United States, and you could just compare with what we currently have in the UK. As I mentioned a couple of weeks ago, the sugar tax has just been introduced in the UK, and we're coming late into that kind of regulatory reform. European countries are far ahead of us in terms of the sugar tax, and perhaps there have been some changes they've seen in the level of consumption. Now, if you look at the question carefully, the first sentence is focused on a data, but quickly says, to what extent will the UK sugar tax impact marketing activities? So we see, number one, consumption level. Number two, sugar tax impact. So we know marketing activities, quickly apply our 4 P's. Activities of companies that are producing energy and sport drinks in terms of products, promotions, what else?
Price,
yeah. Next P. So clearly what we're looking at is UK sugar tax and the impact on these 4 P's. What should we do in terms of the marketing environment? Pastel, correct. Absolutely. And so we have our 4 P's and then we have our pastel. So, what's our P? Anybody? Political? The first E? Could be any of the E's. Yeah? Ecological environment, okay. What's the next one?
Social.
Social cultural, yeah. The next? Another person? How about you? T? Come on. T. Pesto.
Technology.
Yeah. Yeah? And that E, the very important one?
Economical.
And the L? Come on.
Legal.
Okay, the legal environment. Clearly, the sugar tax is coming into law. So there are legal implications, a lot for you to discuss. The sugar tax has some financial implications because of the cost. If we go back to the question, quickly, what kind of players do you identify here? Millennials one, yeah? Any other person? Millennials? Actors, yeah, one?
Yeah, look who's there.
The providers?
Yes, the manufacturers, yeah, the company. Yeah, who are they? Yes, we've got millennials. They are the one consuming. Those producing the drinks. The companies, the manufacturers, Richard Lucas. Who else? Do we have it here? Remember we're talking about sugar tax. Sorry?
Government,
good.
But it's also due for manufacturers of the drinks. Drinks manufacturers are beginning to reformulate their drinks and to promote sugar-free alternatives harder than ever. This can be seen as a success for the tax. Ultimately, the tax is designed to reduce the amount of sugary drinks being consumed in the UK, and it seems the bill has already begun to impact manufacturers.
Yeah. Let's flip the class a bit, as we usually do. Yeah? Would that be alright? Come on, let's get some energy in the class. Let's, yeah, turn it around. Let's go down. Quick. Come on. We have much time. Are you talking for it? Yeah? So whose side, for the actors, whose side do you think is really on, this guy? Government side. Please, are you listening? We're looking at the actors, and from what we've listened to, do you think he was a bit biased? Someone said he's on the middle, the other said factual. Another person said anti-government, kind of, a little bit. Three main actors here, consumers, manufacturers, or what you call producers, and the UK government. So who do you think is really more leaning towards, he's more sympathetic to which of the actors? Manufacturers? That's correct, yes.
Very good.
Yeah. So in your essay, you might think, why not? Yeah.
I just say one problem.
What you're looking for here is one, analyzing the impact of sugar tax on that in terms of the micro environment. And then the impact of sugar tax in terms of the macro environment. So you want to see what impact it will have. Some might have more and some might have less. So you might have more to say about certain things, but you should cover. It's a good argument here, you know, Theresa May is trying to do.
It's more like for her, like almost for her reputation.
For her reputation? Yeah, okay. You could remember your reasoning with facts, with references. Yeah?
The UK ban would apply to drinks with 150 milligrams of caffeine per litre or more, but it would only apply in England, leaving Scotland, Wales and Northern Ireland to make their own decision on whether to bin the drinks.
Let's write down some information that I think will be relevant to our work. Yeah, this video focuses more on consumers, Please write, He's a bit leaning towards you, which is the actors is leaning towards you. Consumers, Good. Now, I need you to research more. Take this with you when you go home over the weekend, or something on Monday. Find out, in terms of the sugar tax itself, from your research, why the sugar tax in the first place? We've been having these drinks for years. 2016, the issue of sugar tax came up. So why sugar tax? What's the problem?
Well, the health one, then.
Health, yeah. In terms of health. So what's that about health? Any other person?
Diabetes,
yes, that's one, yeah. Health, obesity, yes. And what's the implication of that on everybody? Why should we all be concerned about that?
Well,
is the NHS, yeah. Good. Yeah. Negative impact on the NHS? What else? Why should sugar tax affect everybody? Why should governments actually be thinking of a law? A levy? Why?
Because they provide health care for us.
NHS, they provide. Good.
Go on. Yeah, they obviously they provide health care, they have part of their job is to care for their people.
Good.
A good way to do that rather than solve the problem, just stop the problem.
Good. So the aim is to reduce consumption. I'll be in my office. I'll be happy if you have further questions, but I don't think there are other questions we'll have. Thank you very much for coming. I'll see you next week. Thank you.